Jaya Gopi Jana Ballabha Girivardhari. Jashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana. Jashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana. Jamuna Tira Vanachari. Jamuna Tira Vanachari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Gopi Jana Ballabha Girivardhari. Jaya Gopi Jana Ballabha Girivardhari. Jashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana. Jashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana. Jamuna Tira Vanachari. Jamuna Tira Vanachari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Nittai Gaur Hari Bo, Hari Bo, Hari Bo, Hari Bo. Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Prabhupada. Gaur Premanande Hari Haribo Jayong Vishnupad Paramhamsa Paribrajakacharjo Ashtuttara Shatu Shri Srimad Abhay Charanaru Bindu Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupad Ki Jai Ananta Koti Vaishnav Vrinda Ki Jai Namacharjo Shila Haridas Thakur Ki Jai Prem Se Kahu Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shiva Shadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai Shri Shri Radha Krishna Gop Gopinath Shyam Kunda Radha Kunda Giri Govardhan Ki Jai Shri Vrindavan Dham Ki Jai Shri Mathura Dham Ki Jai Shri Jagannath Puri Dham Ki Jai Shri Mayapur Navadiv Dham Ki Jai Ganga Mai Ki Jai Jamuna Mai Ki Jai Bhakti Devi Ki Jai Tulasi Maharani ki jai, Harinam Sankirtan ki jai, Shamobeto Bhakta Vrinda ki jai, Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Go. All glories to the assembled devotees, all glories to the assembled devotees, all glories to the assembled devotees, all glories to Sri Guru and Sri Gaurango, all glories to Srila Prabhupada. Namaṁ Vishnupadāya Krishna Prasthāya Bhūtale Śrīmate Bhakti Vedānta Swāmi Niti Nāmine Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravāni Pracārine Nirviśeṣa Śunyavādī Paścatta Viśvatāri Śrīla Prabhupāda Ki Jai Granthārāj Śrīmad Bhāgavatam Ki Jai Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Narayanam Namaskritya Naranchaiva Naruttamam Devim Sarasatim Vyasam Tato Jaya Mudirai Nashto Prayeshu Abhadreshu Nittam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th Canto, 7th Chapter. What Prahlad learned in the womb. What Prahlad learnt in the womb. Text 29. Tatropaya Shahasranam Ayam Bhagavato Ditaha Jadishvare Bhagavati Yatha Yair Anjasa Ratihi Tatrapayo Sahasranam Tatrapayo Sahasranam Ayam Bhagavato Ditaha Ayam Bhagavato Ditaha Jadishvare Bhagavati Jadishvare Bhagavati Jathayair Anjasaratihi Jathayair Anjasaratihi Tatrapayo Sahasranam Ayam Bhagavato Ditaha Jadishvare Bhagavati Jathayair Anjasaratihi Bhagavato Ditaha Hare Bhagavati Jatha Jairanjasarati Matajis, Sahasrana, Tatra, in that connection, getting out of the entanglement of material conditioning. Upaya, of processes. Sahasranam, of many thousands. Ayam, this. Bhagavata Uditaha. Given by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Yat, which, Ishvare, to the Lord. Bhagavati, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Yatha, as much as, Jai, by which, Anjasa, quickly, Ratihi, attachment with love and affection. Translation by His Divine Grace, Srila Prabhupada. Of the different processes recommended for disentanglement from material life, the one personally explained and accepted by the Supreme Personality of Godhead should be considered all perfect. That process is the performance of duties by which love for the Supreme Lord develops. Please repeat after me. Of the different processes recommended for disentanglement from material life, the one personally explained and accepted by the Supreme Personality of Godhead should be considered all perfect. That process is performed, that process is the performance of duties by which love for the Supreme Lord develops. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Among the linking processes that elevate one from bondage to material contamination, the one recommended by the Supreme Personality of Godhead should be accepted as the best. That process is clearly explained in Bhagavad Gita, where the Lord says, Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam braja. Abandon all varieties of religion and just surrender unto me. This process is the best because the Lord assures, Aham tvam sarva papibhya moksha ishami ma suchaha. I shall deliver you from all sinful reactions. Do not fear. There is no need to be worried, for the Lord Himself assures that He will care for His devotee and save him from the reactions of sinful activities. Material bondage is a result of sinful activities. Therefore, since the Lord assures that He will dissipate the results of fruitive material activities, there is no need to be worried. This process of understanding one's position as a spirit soul and then engaging oneself in devotional service is therefore the best. The entire Vedic program is based on this principle, and one can understand it as recommended in the Vedas. Yasya deve para bhaktir jatha deve tatha gurau tasyaite kathita hi arthaha prakashante mahatmanaha. Unto those great souls who have implicit faith in both the Lord and the spiritual master, all the imports of Vedic knowledge are automatically revealed. This is from Setashatara Upanishad. One must accept the pure devotee, the representative of God, as one's guru, and then offer him all the respect. Then offer him all the respects one would offer the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is the secret of success. For one who adapts this method, the perfect process is revealed. In this verse, the words Jair Anjasa Ratihi indicate that if by offering service and surrendering to the spiritual master, one is elevated to devotional service, and by performing devotional service, one gradually becomes attached to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Because of this attachment to the Lord, one can understand the Lord. In other words, one can understand what the Lord's position is, what our position is, and what our relationship is. All this can be understood very easily by the simple method of Bhakti Yoga. As soon as one is situated on the platform of Bhakti Yoga, the root cause of one's suffering and material bondage is destroyed. This is clearly explained in the next verse, which gives the secret of success. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militang Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Sarasvati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunnavadi paschatta dishatarine Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivashadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Tatrupayo Shahasranam Ayam Bhagavato Ditaha Jadishvare Bhagavati Jathajair Anjasaratihi. Of the different processes recommended for disentanglement from material life, the one personally explained and accepted by the Supreme Personality of Godhead should be considered all perfect. That process is the performance of duties by which love for the Supreme Lord develops. So, Prahlad Maharaj is telling his friends, his 5-6 year old boys in the Gurukul, but Prahlad Maharaj is imparting the highest form of spiritual understanding. How did just a 6-year-old boy could achieve that? So this actually shows, especially from Prahlad Maharaj's description, that spiritual knowledge is never destroyed. It continues as long as one remains on the spiritual path. One, this result of the spiritual advancement remains with him. Prahlad Maharaj was in the womb of his mother at that time. And Narad Muni was imparting this transcendental knowledge to his mother, Kayathu. And sitting in the womb of his mother, Prahlad is listening. And here we can see how this 6-year-old boy received this knowledge when he was in his mother's womb. And what he is imparting is the essence of the Vedic wisdom. Vedas means knowledge. All the knowledges are considered to be Vedas. Now, these knowledges now are categorized in two branches. One branch is flowing in the karmic region, materialistic domain. And that is the Karmakanda section of the Vedas. And then when one wants to get rid of the material bondage, then the Vedas are imparting the Gyanakanda aspect of the Vedas, knowledge aspect. First is karma aspect. When people want to enjoy, the Vedas are giving the prescriptions. Yeah, you want to enjoy, fine, this is the way to enjoy. Enjoyment means you want something and you get it. Fulfillment of desire is another name of happiness. Happiness means fulfillment of desire. One wants something and when he gets it, he is happy. But then he realizes that in spite of getting all that he wanted, still he is not happy. That's the material nature. In the material nature, no one is happy. A poor man wants to be a rich man. And a rich man wants to be a king. And a king wants to be the king of the entire world. And then the king of the entire world wants to become the king of the heavenly planet, Indra. So it just goes on and on and on. One is never happy being situated where he is. That's why the expression, the grass is greener on the other side of the fence. In his present situation, no one is happy. He thinks that I will be happy tomorrow. But a wise man begins to wonder, I'm trying to be happy in so many ways and I got everything that I wanted, but still why I am not happy? That actually takes him to the point of knowledge aspect, Gyanakanda. And that knowledge aspect makes him realize that this material nature is a place of suffering. How can you enjoy in a place of suffering? And not only that, this body is a wonderful instrument for receiving pain. With a body which is meant for receiving pain, in a place which is meant for suffering, how can you enjoy? Does it make sense? This body is a place of, this body is an instrument for suffering? Take any part of your body. A very insignificant part that you don't even think of, your earlobes. Consider in how many ways you can give pain to this part of your body. Take a knife, cut it. Take a stone, smash it. Take a pin, pinch it. This just to name a few. You can think of thousands of ways to inflict pain in this part of the body. And that principle applies to every single part of your body. So what's the conclusion? This body is actually prone to receive pain. Now you consider in how many ways you can give pleasure to this body, these parts of this body. Practically non-existent. So we are in a body, we are situated in a body which is meant for receiving pain in a place that is meant for suffering. How can one enjoy? So the Vedas are then leading step by step through this Gyanakanda section, different branches of philosophy. Naya, Vaisheshika, Sankhya, Yoga. These four branches of philosophy are dealing with the Gyanakanda section. And then, ultimately through the perfection of yoga, through the perfection of the process of Ashtanga yoga, at the stage of Samadhi, one sees the Lord in the heart, Super Soul. And recognizing his greatness and his minuteness. Recognizing his minuteness in the light of the Lord's greatness, he automatically surrenders. Therefore, after yoga samadhi comes surrender. Yogi namopi sarvesham madgatenantaratmanaha shaddhavan bhajate jo mam samyukta tamo mataha. That is the conclusion of all these branches of philosophy. Shaddhavan bhajate jo mam samyukta tamo mataha. He is most intimately connected to me, the Lord is saying. And then the surrender leads to the platform of bhakti. That surrender, sharanagati, is the platform of bhakti. Mamekam sharanam braja. Krishna is instructing, just surrender unto me. And the assurance is, Aham Tvam Sarva Papibhyo Moksha Ishami Masuchaha. I will deliver you from all your sinful reactions. And Prabhupada is pointing out in the purport that Sarva Papibhyo Moksha Ishami is actually indicating liberation from the material bondage and entering into the spiritual world. Because of due to our sinful reactions, we are entangled in this material nature. So when all the sinful reactions are eliminated, no more material bondage. So Prahlad Maharaj is telling his friends what he learnt in the womb of his mother, what he learnt when he was in the womb of his mother from Narad Muni, his spiritual master. He didn't even see him, just heard him. That's why this process is known as Shrota Pantha, the process of hearing. By hearing, we understand. Even though we may not see the personality. We are seeing that today. Just by hearing from Prabhupada's tape, so many people are benefiting. Although they didn't meet Srila Prabhupada. Therefore, when people lament, oh, I didn't meet Srila Prabhupada. Now my response is, doesn't matter whether you have met him personally or not, Prabhupada is present. Just listen to his instructions. Listen to the tapes. It's such a wonderful opportunity to directly hear from Srila Prabhupada. Read his books. Prabhupada is present. Prabhupada is always alive in his instructions. Whether we met him or not doesn't matter. And as a result of that hearing, Dibya Gyan Hridaye Prakashita, the transcendental knowledge is revealed in the heart. Jai Shri Shri Radha Madhava Shriman Mahaprabhu Shakhi Brinda Ki Jai. Jai Shri Shri Prahlad Nrisingha Dev Ki Jai. Jai Shri Shri Pancha Tattva Ki Jai. So, this is the process. Shrota Pantha, the process that enables us to receive transcendental knowledge through hearing. Out of our five senses, although the spiritual domain is beyond our sense perception. It's transcendental. Transcendental means beyond our sense perception. Adhokshaja. Adhokshaja. Akshaja means products of our senses. And adho akshaja means beyond our sense perception. That is what the spiritual reality is. Our senses cannot, the spiritual reality is beyond our senses. Yet one sense can reach that spiritual domain, that is our hearing, ears. Our hands cannot touch that reality. Our eyes cannot see that reality. And so forth. But our ears can perceive that reality. And that revelation the domain is revealed. It comes as a revelation. Dibya Gyan Hridaye Prakashita, as we sing every day. Tene brahma rida adi kavaye muihanti jatsurayaha. The Supreme Personality of Godhead imparted this knowledge, Vedas, brahma rida adi kavaye, in the heart of adi kavi Brahma. So this is how we can see how that reality can be perceived provided we follow the process properly. And here Prahlad Maharaj is pointing out what the process is. He is saying that the process that has been given by the Lord and accepted by the Lord is the all perfect process. Naturally, He is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and the process that He gives, what can be better than that one? Or how can that process have any flaw? So that is, and then accepted aspect, when I was reading that accepted aspect, I was thinking of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, He Himself accepted it, practiced it, and taught us Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Therefore, His teachings is the ultimate. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teachings is the ultimate conclusion of the Vedas. Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is imparting the knowledge, but that is just the beginning stage, as Prabhupada said. Bhagavad Gita is the beginning stage. Then Srimad Bhagavatam is the more advanced stage. Because Krishna is ending Bhagavad Gita, Mam Ekam Sharanam Braja, surrender. But what happens when we surrender, that has been explained in Srimad Bhagavatam. Bhagavad Gita ends with Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mam Ekam Sharanam Braja. Srimad Bhagavatam begins with Dharma Prajjita Kaitava Atra Parama Nirmat Saranam Satam. Sarva Dharman Parityajya, give up all your so-called dharmas and religions. Just surrender unto Me. And Srimad Bhagavatam is beginning. When one surrenders, when one gives up all these so-called materialistic dharmas or duties, then the heart becomes completely purified. Parama Nirmat Saranam. When the heart becomes completely cleansed, then only Vedam Vastavamatra Vastu. One gets to understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So this is how we see Bhagavatam is where Bhagavad Gita ends, Srimad Bhagavatam begins. But then also, Bhagavatam is giving various descriptions, various anecdotes, various historical descriptions, and the knowledge is there. And to clarify that knowledge, there is a need of a teacher. Jaho Bhagavato Paro Bhagavato Sthane. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu instructing. Go study Srimad Bhagavatam under the guidance of a Bhagavat. Otherwise you won't understand Srimad Bhagavatam. With your scholarship you won't understand Srimad Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam must be understood from a devotee. So, therefore, unless and until we come to the point of understanding or hearing Srimad Bhagavatam from a bona fide devotee of the Lord who assumes the role of a teacher, we cannot possibly understand Srimad Bhagavatam, the real meaning of Srimad Bhagavatam, the real essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. We find, although these points are there, people didn't understand. Like before Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, people did not really know that Vrindavan is the highest region. They used to think Vaikuntha is the highest region and Krishna is an incarnation. Although practically at the beginning of Bhagavatam it is saying that Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. Ete Changsha Kalapungsha, Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. All these are incarnations. All these expansions of the Lord are His incarnations. But Krishna is the original Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan Swayam. Still people didn't understand. Until Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and revealed it. Those who studied under the guidance of bona fide spiritual master, they did understand that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made it known to everybody all across. Mahaprabhu, what is Mahaprabhu's teachings? Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. Aradhya Bhagavan Brajeshotanay. Son of Nanda Maharaj. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. Staddhama Vrindavanam. His abode is Vrindavan. Not Mathura, not Dwarka. Vrindavan, specific. Vrindavan. Krishna of Vrindavan, who is the son of Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda, is the Supreme Personality of God. Only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu could give that understanding. It goes to the extent of, as I mentioned, not Krishna of Mathura, not the Krishna who is the son of Vasudeva and Devaki. No, that not that Krishna is the original Supreme Personality of Godhead. The son of Nanda Maharaj is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Brajeshotanay, staddhama Vrindavanam. His abode is Vrindavan. And Ramma Kachi Dupashana Brajabodhu Vargena Jakulpita. The way the cowherd damsels worship Krishna, that is the highest form of worship. While others were, even the Vaishnavas were thinking, why Krishna had to perform such a pastimes, having an affair with other people's wives and young girls? Why Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, had to do that? Because jad jad acharati srishtas tatta devetaro jana. As a exalted personality does, the common man follows. So people will follow that activity. That's why there was the need of Krishna coming as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and pointing out that is the highest form of worship. Why the highest form? Because when one is able to give up everything for the sake of Krishna, that's the highest form of worship. The way the gopis did. They didn't care for anything. The woman's greatest ornament is chastity and shame. They didn't care for that. What people talked about them, thought about them, they didn't care for that. For the sake of Krishna, they were prepared to give that up. That's the highest form of worship. Griha Shinkhala. The women are generally tied down to their household responsibilities. It's kind of a chain. They have given up. They broke out of that chain and went to meet Krishna in the dead of the night. Not even caring what others will think about them. That is the highest form of worship. And that is what Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu pointed out. And Sanatana Goswami revealed it in his Brihad Bhagavatamrita, how Vrindavan is the highest region of the spiritual sky and the gopis' love for Krishna is the highest, especially Srimati Radharani's love for Krishna. And then through the discussion with Ramananda Roy, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu revealed it. Through Ramananda Roy, he revealed, going step by step by step. And with a common sense also we can see. Just with a common sense we can consider. How many of you are married here? How many of you are married? Please raise your hands. Will you get upset if your wives go after Krishna? Or will you be proud of it? So that's the answer. So the husbands become proud when their wives go to Krishna. So that is the Leela Purushottam. Krishna, who is simply performing his leelas, his pastimes, for his pleasure and for the pleasure of other. Pleasure of other devotees. So that is the teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So the ultimate point of Srimad Bhagavatam is that. The ultimate point of Srimad Bhagavatam is not only the process that has been given by the Lord, but the way He Himself practiced it as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and the knowledge that He has given, that is the ultimate conclusion. Thank you all very much. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Gaur Premanande Hari.
কোন ব্যক্তি যদি কৃষ্ণের শরণে শরণাগত হয় তাহলে তিনি কৃষ্ণ তাকে সমস্ত পাপ থেকে মুক্ত করবেন তাহলে তিনি এই জগৎ থেকে মুক্ত হয়ে ভগবানের কাছে ফিরতে পারবেন যদি কোন ব্যক্তি পুণ্য কর্ম করে পাপ কর্ম না করে তাহলে তার কি হবে
পুণ্য কর্ম করলে স্বর্গে যাবে
সে কি জগতে
আর ভগবানের সেবা করলে ভগবানের কাছে যাবে ওকে দ্য কোশ্চেন ইজ ইউ সেড দ্যাট ওয়েন ওয়ান সারেন্ডার্স টু কৃষ্ণ হি বিকামস free from all sinful reactions. But what happens when one performs pious activities? The answer is that when one performs pious activities, he goes to heavenly planet. But when one surrenders to Krishna and renders devotional service, he goes to Krishna beyond this material nature. Now, this is one question or two. Who did it come from? From you. This is one question or two? Two questions. You mentioned Divogyan Ride Prakashito, transcendental knowledge is revealed within the heart. Then you said the ear is the only sense by which we can perceive the spiritual reality. So, are the ear and the heart connected, or do the process of hearing and revelation in the heart take place simultaneously? Good question. Yes, there is a connection. Karno randhro patho diya ridhi majhe probeshya borishoy shudha anukhan. Bhakti Vinod Thakur is saying that through the passage of the ears, this transcendental sound vibration enters into the heart, and there it keeps on showering nectar. So that is how it works, and that's the connection. The ear is the passage through which it enters into heart, and then it does everything in that region, in the heart. So, Dibbogyan, as a result, the transcendental knowledge is revealed in the heart. It's not that the ears can perceive that domain, or rather the more accurate expression will be, the ears can receive the informations from that domain. The informations from that domain is coming through the scriptures, through the words of Krishna, through the words of Krishna's devotees. And they're coming through the ears and entering into the region of the heart and make all kinds of wonderful things happen there. Next question is, you mentioned that realizing one's minuteness in front of the greatness of the Lord, one surrenders from that point, bhakti starts to the degree we surrender to that degree, bhakti to the degree we surrender, to that degree, Krishna awards us. Does that indicate that surrender is a dynamic, continuous process which grows as our devotion increases? Yes. As our devotion increases, our surrender increases. As our surrender increases, our devotion increases. But first is surrender. But then again, the surrender comes through the process of devotion. Without devotion, we cannot surrender. So that is how it works. Which one is first, which one is after, is difficult to ascertain. Like whether the egg came first or the chicken came first. So the transcendental reality is beyond our intellectual comprehension. Yes, I think you have to take the mic.
So sarma dharma paritraja, just surrender, abandon all varieties of religion and just surrender unto me, and I will save you from all sinful reactions. Sounds a little bit like, to me on occasion, like a business contract.
And Krishna?
Like a business contract. You do this and you'll get that. And Prabhupada said, do not fear, Krishna will save you from all sinful reactions. So my fear isn't that Krishna won't uphold his side of the bargain. My fear is that my surrender is not enough. So my question is, at what point is the surrender sufficient to fulfill the business contract?
Good question. Thank you. Yeah. In simple words, I will say, it's a business contract with an insurance policy along with that. The contract is signed and the insurance is also given, right? And there is no way that contract can fail. So, you know, this is the wonderful mercy that Krishna is bestowing upon us. And the Supreme Personality can do that because we are His parts and parcels. Because we are like His children and He is like the Father. The Father will go to any extent to bring His children back to Himself. All the children have to do is simply turn towards Him and say, Daddy, I want to go back to you. That's about all we have to do. Thank you. Yes.
Hare Krishna. Thank you, Maharaj, for the nice class. You were saying that spiritual knowledge is never lost. So I was thinking that maybe in this case, knowledge and realization are two different things, because sometimes we can know something but forget. Like we hear a class, we feel very inspired, it all makes sense. But then after some time, that inspiration goes, we become confused again. Or we do something and we learn a lesson from something which happens and we feel like, okay, I'm not going to do that again. But then later on, we do the same stupid thing again, as if we forgot everything. So can you explain?
Yeah. Yeah. When I mentioned that it's never lost, I also mentioned as long as one remains on the spiritual path. Because we find that sometimes it gets lost. Like example, Prahlad Maharaj's own mother. Right? Narad Muni actually told her, and I'm sure, you know, she was inspired when she was listening. You know, I mean, otherwise how could the child in the womb could have been influenced by that, you know. But the thing is, she lost it because she gave up the devotional process. Whereas Prahlad Maharaj did not. And what you said is also very pertinent, very relevant, that it's not just knowledge, it's the realization. Like, not knowledge means intellectually you're memorizing something, not that kind of knowledge. It is a thing that happens in the heart, and then meaning it is affecting the soul. And the influence that it had on the soul, this knowledge or these instructions, will remain with the soul forever. Only the matter of is, you know, coming, the soul coming into the proper atmosphere of devotional service, then that knowledge becomes revealed or exposed again. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Okay, so thank you all very much. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. We'll end the class with a short kirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Nittai Gaur Hari Bo, Hari Bo, Hari Bo. Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Prabhupada. I just thought of clarifying one point, that is when I said, Jajadat morally say that Krishna's activities in Vrindavan is not appropriate because Jaja Jatirati Srishta, as what a great man does, common man follows. But here we have to understand that Krishna's activities, Lila Purushottam, Krishna's activities can never be imitated or should never be imitated and cannot be imitated. Just as we are saying, in one hand, Krishna is Gopijana Ballabha, but at the same time, he is Giri Baradhari. So if you want to imitate Krishna's Gopijana Ballabha aspect, then you also follow Krishna's Giri Baradhari aspect. First you lift a mountain and then you can think of imitating that aspect. The main point is, Lila Purushottam, Krishna's activities should never be imitated. Marjada Purushottam, Ramchandra's activities should be imitated. And Krishna's activities as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that should be activated, but not Lila Purushottam, Krishna's activities. Why? Because Krishna's Leelas are in the topmost region of the spiritual sky. And this material nature is the reflection. In a reflection, the topmost appears with the lowermost. Krishna's topmost activities, when reflected in the material platform, is the most abominable activity. That's how we have to recognize that. Thank you very much. One question from the internet. Jamuna Priya. To the dust of your lotus feet. All glories to glory, Srila Prabhupada. My understanding is Srila Prabhupada has always said it doesn't matter if you are Christian or Muslim, just follow your path of God sincerely. If that is correct, then can you please elaborate what Krishna means when he says, Sarva Dharman Parityaja, what exactly it meant? Yeah, Jamuna Priya, I hope you are still in the is still connected. So, you see, first of all, we have to understand that when Krishna is speaking about dharma, he is not talking about Hindu dharma, Muslim dharma, Christian dharma and so forth. Christianity, Islam and all that was not there at that time. When Krishna is speaking about dharma, he is talking about materialistic dharma. There are two types of dharma according to the Vedas. One is nitya dharma and the other is the naimittik dharma. Nitya dharma means the dharma of the soul and naimittik dharma means the dharma of the body. So what Krishna is telling that all the dharmas pertaining to the body, all the way up to Varnashram dharma, which is pertaining to the body and the modes of material nature, all those have to be given up. and just surrender unto Krishna, because that is the nitya dharma or the dharma of the soul. So, and when Prabhupada says that one can follow his own religion properly and developing his relationship with God, here also we have to understand that yes, there are different dharmas. They can be classified as dharma of the soul, but at the same time we also have to recognize that there are different levels, just like a knowledge in a primary school, a subject you study in a primary school, then you go to secondary school, then you go to high school, and so forth. So similarly, these dharmas that are being practiced, yes, they're talking about God there, but the understanding that they're giving about the God and the soul is very preliminary, very basic, as if they are the lessons of kindergarten, lessons of primary school, and so forth. But what the Vedas are giving is covering from primary school all the way up to PhD. That is the difference between those religions and the Vedas. And the idea is that if they remain on the proper path, then gradually from primary they'll be elevated to secondary and so forth. And the ultimate consideration is that ultimately they all will come to Krishna consciousness if they're following the right path. Thank you very much. All glories to Srila Prabhupada.